Good morning, students. So in the last class we have completed third unit, that is Shaper, Planer and Slotter, right? Now we are moving to the fourth unit, that is cutting fluids, coolants and lubricants. Cutting fluids, coolants and lubricants. So this is also small unit as approaching mission. So let's see. During metal cutting process, metal is removed in the form of chips. As we have recall, three units. In that three units, we are removing the metals in the form of chips in lathe machine, and broaching and shaper, planer, slotter. The metal is removed in the form of chips, right? So during this operation, so there is a friction between the tool and workpiece, and the chip which is removed causes the temperatures to rise. So during the operation, there is a temperature rise between the tool and workpiece, right? This temperature is so high and leads to welding of chips onto the tool face and workpiece. So this temperature is so high. If the temperature is leads to so high, the chips which are removed from the workpiece are welded to the tool face and also workpiece. So thus reducing the tool life and efficiency of machining. Okay. So these are the drawbacks we have observed while doing the machining operations like lathe, shaper, planer, slotter and broaching machine. Okay, during metal cutting process, the metal is removed in the form of chips. So due to this, there is a friction between the tool and workpiece is happened. Due to this, there is a temperature rise. If the temperature is so high, there may be chance to welding of chips onto the tool and workpiece face. So due to this, there is a reducing the tool life and also reducing the efficiency of the machining, right? And also rising temperature not only done the welding of tool face and also causes the deformation of workpiece. Due to this temperature rise, there may be deformation of workpiece and it leads to change in grain structure also, thereby varying properties of work. So due to temperature rise, there may be chance of changing of grain structure and there may be chance of change of the properties of workpiece. Due to this temperature rise, why the temperature is increases? Because there is a friction between workpiece and the tool. So due to this temperature rise may be happened. So to overcome the above, it is must to have some means to reduce friction. So we want to reduce this temperature rise. The temperature rise cause is mainly because of friction. So if we reduce the friction between the tool and workpiece, ultimately we are reducing the temperature rise also. So our main aim is to overcome the above. It is must to have some means to reduce friction. So this is achieved by the use of cutting fluids, coolants, lubricants, right? So this may be achieved by the use of cutting fluids, coolants and lubricants. The above action due to the use of lubricants, cutting fluids and coolants, we are getting increasing the machine efficiency and we increases the tool life and also provide free movement between the mating parts because there is a reduction of friction, right? The simple words, we can tell that during machining operation there is a temperature rise because of friction between the tool and workpiece contact. If the temperature is so high, there may be chance of welding of chips onto the workpiece or tool face. And also the temperature rise may change the grain structure and also leads to the change of properties of the workpiece and also causes the deformation of workpiece. to overcome all these problems, we have to use the following liquids, that is cutting fluids, coolants and lubricants. By use of these, there is a chance to reduce the friction. So after, if we are reducing the friction, we are achieving the increasing the machine efficiency and tool life, and provide free movement between moving parts. Right? So on completion of this lecture, we are going to know the definition and functions of cutting fluids, properties of cutting fluids, and types of cutting fluids. So what is cutting fluid? Definition: any substance that is applied to the cutting zone during metal machining operation is called cutting fluid. The substance is applied to the cutting zone during metal machining operation is called cutting fluid, and the term cutting fluid denotes to those coolants and lubricants that are used in metal machining operation. The substance is applied to the cutting zone during metal machining operation is called, during machining operation we are using one substance to reduce the friction between the tool and workpiece. That substance is called as a cutting fluid. The term cutting fluid denotes indicates to those coolants and lubricants. Coolants and lubricants are the cutting fluids and that are used in metal machining operations. The functions of cutting fluids to obtain. What are the functions of cutting fluids? We are getting these benefits by using the cutting fluids. That is, we are to obtain best surface finish and dimensional accuracy, because by using these cutting fluids we are getting the surface finish and dimensional accuracy is more, and also carry away the heat that is generated during the machining operation. Right? You are observed while doing fitting operations, while doing cutting using of saw and saw, you are using liquid water. You are pouring water onto the cutting surfaces. Why you are using means you are reducing the friction between the saw and the workpiece, and also remove the chips which are removed from the workpiece while you are doing the cutting operation. Okay, so to carry away the heat that is generated during machining, and also cool the tool and the workpiece. Because of heat, there may be change of properties. So for that reason, it may be cool the workpiece, and also improve the machinability. Machinability means it is removing of material from its surfaces easily, right? While doing lathe operations, we are removing the unwanted material easily from the workpiece. So that property is called machinability. Okay, to prevent adhesion of chips to the tool and workpiece. Adhesion means sticking the chips to the tool face and workpiece. So we can also prevent adhesion of chips to the tool and workpiece. And also flush away chips from the cutting zone. We are flush away the chips from the cutting zone after removing from the workpiece. And also reduce the friction at chip tool and work tool interface. Right? So these are the functions of cutting fluids. So the fluid which is undergoing cutting fluid, we are called, it has to possess these properties. It has to be cutting fluid. It has the following properties. That is, to get the optimum benefits, the cutting fluid should possess the following qualities. If the fluid which are having these properties, we can tell that it is a cutting fluid. Otherwise, we are not used as it as a cutting fluid. Understood? So it has to be good lubricating properties. Lubrication means it is reduces the friction between the two interfaces, and high heat absorption capacity. It has to absorb the heat while generating when the machining operation taking place, so it has to be absorbed, and no fire or accidental hazards. Fire and accidental hazards also reduce, right? And not to emit toxic odors and vapors harmful to the operator. తెలుగులో చెప్పాలంటే విషపూరితమైన వాయువులు అన్నమాట ఇవన్నీ. సో ఇట్ హ్యాస్ నాట్ టు ఎమిట్ టాక్సిక్ ఆర్డర్స్ అండ్ వేపర్స్ హార్మ్ఫుల్ టు ది ఆపరేటర్ షుడ్ బి నాన్ పాయిజనస్ అండ్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు బి లో విస్కాసిటీ రెసిస్టెన్స్ టు ఫ్లో షుడ్ బి లో సో ఈజీలీ ఫ్లోయింగ్ వి నీడ్ కట్టింగ్ ఫ్లూయిడ్స్ హ్యాస్ టు బి ఈజీ టు ఈజీలీ ఫ్లో సో these properties and prevent rusting of the machine and working surfaces. If you are using cutting fluids while in the machining operation, it has the cutting fluid does not cause the rusts on the surfaces between the workpiece and cutting board. So prevent rusting of machine and the work surfaces. Should not produce fog, smoke during use, and it is suitable for a variety of cutting operations. And should not discolor the finished work pieces. And it should be chemically stable, and it should impart anti-welding properties. High flash point should not deteriorate in storage. Okay, high flash point means tondaraga burn avadannamata. Flash point anedi ko unte okay na manaku burning anedi avadu cutting fluids anedi burn ayithe inke mundu inka heat ekkuvaipothadi kada. So high flash point should be possess and should not deteriorate in storage. Storage lo pettukoni mana supply chestuntam kada storage tank ni paadu cheyadannamata, right? And coming to the types of cutting fluids, the cutting fluids are classified into five main groups, that is water soluble oils or compounds, straight oils, that is mineral oils and fatty oils, chemical additive oils, sulfurized oils and chlorinated oils, chemical compounds, solid lubricants. So these are the cutting fluids classified into five main groups: water soluble oils or compounds, straight oils, chemical additive oils, chemical compounds, solid lubricants, right? Selection of cutting fluids. The selection of proper cutting fluids for any particular application depends upon cutting tool material, workpiece material, operation being performed, cost factor, service expected, cutting condition. So ikkada mana indaka chusina enti types of cutting fluid chusnam, functions of cutting fluid chusnam, properties of cutting fluid chusnam. Right now this, we are moving to the selection of cutting fluids based on cutting tool material. Ante suit avali ok cutting fluid ki and material ki maybe properties difference valla there may be damage to the cutting tool material or work piece material because of some particular cutting fluid. So for that reason we have to keep in mind which cutting fluid is used for a particular cutting tool material and workpiece material, right? This may be depends on the properties of the cutting fluids and at the same time properties of the workpiece and cutting tool material. So based on this we have to use the particular cutting fluid to the particular operation and particular workpiece material and particular cutting tool material, and also we have to keep in mind the cost factor also. If all the values, I mean all the properties are matched and we are selecting one cutting fluid for some particular applications, and we have to keep in mind the cost factor also. If the cost is more, the manufacturing cost is increases, so we have to keep in mind this cost factor also. And service expected, if we are using some particular cutting fluid, if the service time is less, that we have to replace this cutting fluids frequently, the manufacturing cost also increases. So for the reason we are expecting service condition also, service expected and cutting condition also, right? So these have the proper cutting fluid manam select chesukovalante, we have to keep in this in mind what is the cutting tool material and what is the workpiece material, what are the operation operation means it may be turning, straight turning, taper turning, shaper, planing operation, and also cost factor, service expected, cutting condition. We have to keep all these points in our mind and select the proper cutting fluid. So here some of the examples for different operations based on. So here process material, that is aluminium, and the operation is turning operation. So we are using soluble oil. Grinding and drilling, we are using kerosene lard oil. Milling and planing, soluble oil, lard oil, mineral oil. Sawing operation, soluble oil, and broaching operation, sulfuric chlorinated oil. And here the material, workpiece material is copper, and the operation is turning, we are using dry soluble oil. If the operation is grinding and drilling, we are using dry soluble oil and kerosene. If it is operation is milling and planing, that is soluble oil. So based on material and process. So this is material and these are the process. Based on this, we are using these type of cutting fluids, coolants or lubricants. So these are the some of the examples. So if the material is plain carbon steel, we are using in turning operation soluble oil, milling, drilling. So examples likewise. And merits of cutting fluids and coolants, we can take the functions as merits. The cutting fluids may carry away the chips and also drive away scale and dirt, and it improve the surface finish, and it protect the finished surface from corrosion, and it increase the tool life, and may improve machinability, reduce machining forces, provide lubrication, and provides cushioning effect between the tool and workpiece, right? So these are the merits of the cutting fluids and coolants and lubricants. Okay, so far we have covered in today's lecture, that is introduction to cutting fluids, liquids, coolants and lubricants, and also the functions of cutting fluids and properties of cutting fluids, types of cutting fluids, selection of cutting fluids, and merits of the cutting fluids. Okay, so today I am going to stop this lecture. Thank you.